Good evening. On behalf of all of us at Shenendehowa High School, I would like to welcome you to tonight's Senior Award Ceremony. We'll begin our program with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We are grateful to be able to celebrate many of our seniors here tonight. The past 2 months have certainly been difficult and a challenge for so many of us. We have known the class of 2020 was full of impactful leaders. Their ability to adapt to our current situation in conjunction with a positive, forward-thinking approach has forever solidified the legacy of our seniors. Students, you are inspiring to all of us. You make all of us at Shenandoah High School excited to come to work every day as it is a special place to teach and learn. To our parents and guardians, and to all family members, we thank you for the support you have given your children. It has had tremendous impact forming the foundation to propel them to the fine young adults we recognize tonight. We are fortunate to have an extensive program this evening. Much of this would not be possible without the generous support of the scholarships that have been established. We offer our gratitude to all the individuals and organizations that support scholarships for our students. We do have a lengthy program, and we're going to get right into it. Congratulations to all the well-deserved recognitions being received. We are proud of you and excited for what the future holds. At this time, I would like to introduce Superintendent of Schools, Dr. L. Oliver Robinson.
Thank you very much, Mr. Gastinoni. First of all, I'd like to say on behalf of the Board of Education, congratulations to all our awardees and recipients. Also, I'd like to say to all our educators, recognizing that where our students are is a result of your hard work and your support of them. And to those who found it not robbery to provide these tremendous scholarship opportunities for our students, thank you very much. Each year, I'm impressed by the magnitude of scholarships, and also, quite frankly, with you, the various scholarships that we offer to our students. And finally, to our students and our recipients, let me put my comments in context. Recently, I had an interview, and the person asked me, why do I do what I do? It was an interesting question, somewhat perplexing, because I thought, I wonder what's the motivation behind the question. And as I stood there, I thought, well, pretty simple. I do what I do because I feel privileged to do what I do. I share that with our young people because I'm so privileged to be a part of this system that helped you grow over the years. And as we recognize you for your various accomplishments and achievements, I feel even more so. And so to you, I want to say thank you. Thank you for being the wonderful young people who you are. Thank you for being the great students who you are. And thank you for being a wonderful senior class. In a few short weeks, we'll celebrate you again with your commencement. But tonight, we'll pause to recognize your brilliance, recognize your talents, recognize your perseverance. And for that, I say congratulations. You're all deserving of the awards and the recognitions that you're receiving tonight. And finally, to our families, thank you so much. Thank you so much for supporting our students. Our students, your children, thank you so very much. Congratulations to all.
Thank you, Dr. Robinson. Always inspiring words, and we appreciate you being here tonight. At this time, I'd like to introduce our musical performance, Chicken Full by Pee Wee Ellis, arranged and directed by Mr. Brian Carucci. The We'll begin our awards with Principal's Awards this evening. The first is a valedictorian for the class of 2020. This is awarded to the top academic student in the class. This year, the valedictorian is Kenny Jeong. Continuing with the Principal's Awards, the salutatorian for the class of 2020. This is awarded to the number two ranked academic student in the class. This year, the recipient is Nicole Cheatham. The Harold Voigt Scholarship. This is presented to the top male who has attained the highest four-year average in overall academic achievement at the time of graduation. This year, the recipient is Kenny Jeong. Continuing with the Harold Voigt Scholarship, this is presented to the top female senior who's attained the highest four-year average in academic achievement at the time of graduation. This year, the recipient, Nicole Cheatham. The New York State Academic Excellence Scholarship. The recipients this year are Mary Ruchero, Nicole Cheatham, Connor Feeney, Annabelle Flatland, Kenny Jeong, Jacob Miller, Young Ni, Emma Norris, Jessica Pepe, Anna Perez, John Ratalos, Huda Raymond, Michaela Surratt, Calla Schultz, Andrew Schusterman, Baiha Sun, Christopher Vinciguerra, and Evelyn Zayo. The National Merit Scholarship Commended Recognition. The recipients this year, Brianna Beck, Matthew Carpenter, Jonathan Eisner, Dominic Emphasis, Julietta Felider, Annabelle Flatland, Duncan Hill, Zachary Lassiter, Kadron Leyen, Jacob Miller, Anna Perez, Tiffany Pottenberg, Bargave Ramurthy, Bradley Rowe, Michaela Surratt, Baiha Sun, Thomas Weedman, and Maximilian Wojcik. The National Merit Scholarship Finalist Recognition. To achieve the status of merit finalist requires achievement in the top less than 1% of U.S. high school graduating seniors who took the exam. This award is one of the highest forms of recognition that a high school senior can achieve. The recipients of finalist recognition this year are Julietta Felider, Annabelle Flatland, Zachary Lassiter, and Michaela Surratt. Continuing, the National Merit Scholarship winners. There are 2,500 National Merit Scholarship winners from approximately 1.6 million students who entered the National Scholarship Program. This year, we are proud to announce the recipients are Annabelle Flatland and Zachary Lassiter. The Corporal Richard Warren Memorial Award. This award is presented to a senior who has demonstrated creative talent in contemporary art. This year, the recipient is Jiyoungna Park. The Business and Marketing Educators Association, BMEA, Outstanding Business Student Award. This is awarded to an outstanding student in business education. This year, the recipient is Bianca Carzo. The Business Education Department, Joan A. Campisi, Outstanding Attitude Award. This award is presented to an outstanding business student for attitude, cooperation, and teamwork. This student is pursuing a 2 or 4 year degree. This year, the recipient is Jason Marincek. The DECA Club Award. This award is given to a graduating senior who's actively participated in DECA events and held a leadership role within our DECA chapter. This year, the recipient is Michael Marincek. The Future Business Leaders of America, FBLA Scholarship. This award is given to a graduating senior who is pursuing a degree in business and has achieved excellence in leadership and service. This year, the recipient is Maria Carzo. The High School East Shenteague Scholarship. This is presented to seniors who have completed at least 2 business classes, are attending an accredited post-secondary school, pursuing a degree in business-related fields. They are a concerned member of the Shen community, and it is based on character and academic performance. This year, the recipients are Julia Cavagnolo and Nicole Solowiski. The Dora P. Myers Theater Award. This is awarded to 2 seniors who have shown an interest in theater over a 3 or 4 year period through participation on stage or backstage in both the play and musical or in classrooms by taking masterpieces of drama or literature of the musical theater. In addition, the recipients have shown such personal characteristics as leadership, honesty, and community. This year, the recipients are Amy Morissette and Peter Sharmer. The Herb Safran Scholarship. This award is presented to seniors who are considering pursuing a college degree in teaching English or writing as a career. On behalf of the Safran family, I will be reading their message. There comes a time in all of our lives when we learn to think. In some people, this sparks a need to teach others to think, to understand human nature, and to understand the nature of war and the ability of man to devolve into his basic instincts. Such a man was Herbert Safran. Mr. Safran was an English teacher, department chair, mentor, husband, and father. His passion was literature of the Holocaust. In 1975, Mr. Safran championed a new course offering in New York, in the state of New York, to explore exactly that, literature of the Holocaust. And he served as the teacher of that course here at Shenandoah. The course examined the writing of some amazing authors forged by incredible events, writers like William Styron and a young girl named Anne Frank. From these writers, Mr. Safran taught modern-day high school students the horror that a man is capable of when we lose the capacity to think for ourselves. He taught the concept of empathy so his students can envision themselves in the situations relived through the authors who experienced man's greatest inhumanity. His students were moved, they learned, and they were changed, all through the power of the written word. The words themselves were often depictions of events that seemed impossible to comprehend for modern students. But Mr. Safran took the time to relate to current day attitudes and how peer pressure could persuade people to take part in activities in which they would not normally participate. In a time before Schindler's List, Herb Safran converted words in a book into life-altering lessons that caused his students to reevaluate their relationships, their definitions of friend, and their own values and ethics. Having battled debilitating arthritis for much of his adult life, his passion, nonetheless, was to teach compassion and an understanding of the nature of man and ourselves. He remained optimistic about the future of mankind, and especially the future of our Shenandoah students. In honor of Herb Safran's dedication to writing, and the lessons taught to generations beyond our own through words and print, his family is proud to present this scholarship to two writers from this year's graduating class who have shown an exemplary ability to express themselves through the written word and a desire to keep writing. We challenge you to develop and continue your path to becoming the voice of your time, of this time. Congratulations from Jim Cannon, class of 1976, and his wife, Lori Safran, class of 1979, and the rest of the Safran family. This year, the recipients are Megan Betters and Kennedy Morse. The Diane B. Warner Tri-M Music Honor Society Scholarship. This scholarship is offered to a senior who is a member of the Shenandoah Tri-M Honor Society in good standing and has fulfilled community service and attendance requirements. They are an active musician with dedication to Tri-M through participation and involvement in Tri-M sponsored events, and they will be pursuing a degree in music. This year, the recipient is Emma Norris. The Friends of Music Shenandoah Awards. The Friends of Music of Shenandoah, or FOMS, is a group of parents, students, teachers, and community members who believe that music is a vital part of a student's educational and social development. In 1996, Friends of Music of Shenandoah introduced the first Friends of Music Award. This year, Friends of Music is pleased to offer three awards at $1,000 apiece. The award recipients are students that embody the mission of Friends of Music, have made a commitment to music learning throughout high school, have grown as an individual through music, and demonstrate a passion for music through their experiences as musicians or their influence as a musician on their family, friends, school, or community. Congratulations and best wishes to this year's recipients, Sarah Ubera, Samantha Ivy, and Emma Norris. The Norma Gordon Memorial Band Award. This is awarded to a senior who has leadership in performing group, good academic standing, is friendly, non-judgmental, and ready to go the extra mile. This year, the recipient is Delia Martin. The NISMA Conference All-State Music Festival Award. Each year, the New York State School Music Association selects students from across New York State who demonstrate superior musicianship and musical ability to the highest level to participate in New York State School Music Association's Winter Conference in Rochester. Students are selected from thousands who compete statewide for the opportunity for this highest honor. This year, the recipients are Chia Ting Cheng, Gracie Garrett, Samantha Ivy, Matthew Joseph, Heyoon Kim, and Melanie Kruger. The Saratoga Warren County Music Educators Scholarship. This award is presented to the graduating seniors who have shown outstanding dedication to their music. This year, the recipients are Charles Bub IV, Chi Ting Chang, and Matthew Joseph. The William McElroy Award. This is Shenandoah Music Department Award that is given to a senior band student in recognition of musical achievements and citizenship while at Shenandoah, in honor of Mr. William McElroy, the first band director at Shenandoah High School. This year, the recipient is Melanie Kruger. The Boys Physical Education Award is awarded to an outstanding senior boy or boys for qualities demonstrated through mind, body, and spirit by participation in physical education class and or athletics. This year, the recipients are Paul Getz III and Joseph Meyer. The Girls Physical Education Award, again, awarded to an outstanding senior girl for qualities demonstrated through mind, body, and spirit by participation in physical education class and or athletics. This year, the recipient, Annabelle Sala. The Mayflower Compact Award. The recipients were selected from the Society of Mayflower Descendants in the state of New York and will be recognized for their excellence in the study of history at the highest level at Shenandoah High School. This year, the recipients are Sarah Casal and John Rolatos. The Shenandoah High School Social Studies Department Award. A book award given to students who enjoy and excel in social studies and have demonstrated leadership and good citizenship skills. This year, the recipients are Morsel Amery, Caitlin Jennings, Huda Raymond, and Peyton Sophie. The Shenandehowa High School Social Studies Person of Character Award. This award is being awarded to students being recognized for their perseverance and positive character traits demonstrated in the social studies classroom. This year, the recipients are Bianca Carzo and Thomas Landers IV. Illuminating Engineering Society Award. Douglas A. Callender Junior Memorial Award is presented to a senior by the Illuminating Engineering Society, who will continue education in architecture, electrical engineering, lighting design, or interior design. This year, the recipient is Jonathan Eisner. Technology Education Outstanding Achievement Award. Presented to a student by the Technology Department who has made contributions to technology education. This year, the recipient is Kyle Meyer. The Shenandoah High School Latin Scholar Recognition Award. This year, the recipient is Kenny Jeong. Shenandoah High School Love of World Languages Award. This award is given to a student who has shown extraordinary interest in languages both in and outside of the classroom and will pursue further studies in world languages. This year, the recipient is Chase Talheim. Shenandoah High School World Language Department Awards in Chinese. This year, the recipient is Matilda Tristan. The Shenandoah High School World Language Department Award in French. The recipient this year is Jessica Pepe. Shenandoah High School World Language Department Award in German. This year, the recipient is Nilofar Sarian. Shenandoah High School World Language Department Award in Latin. This year, the recipient is Annabelle Sala. Shenandoah World Language Department Award in Spanish. The recipient this year, Baiha Sun. The Schenectady Chapter College of St. Rose Alumni Association, Mother Rose of Lima Foreign Language Award. This is awarded to a junior or senior with high academic average in Latin expressing interest in attending St. Rose or another college. This year, the recipient is Emma Norris. The National Latin Exam winners, Gold Summa Cum Laude Awards. The recipients this year, Mary Ruchero, Priya Duda, Catherine Hefner, Kenny Jeong, Emma Norris, Tiffany Pottenberg, and Annabelle Sala. The National Latin Exam winners, Silver Maxima Cum Laude. The recipients this year are Colin Cook, Caitlin Lamb, Kevin Maynard, Sarah Pitts, Olivia Timms, and Christopher Vinciguerra. The National Latin Exam winners, Magna Cum Laude. The recipients this year, Grace Bissell, Matthew Carpenter, B. Bianca Carzo, Mackenzie Comito, Caitlin Effner, Alexandra Fabrice, Isabella Mayhew, Jesse Nyman, Noah Pedroso, and Ethan Quinlan. The National Latin Exam winners, cum laude. The 2020 recipients are John Lipinski and Maximilian Wojcik. The Shenandehowa High School Unsung Hero Award. Last year, the high school partnership team, with the support of the PTSA, created a new recognition called the Shenandehowa High School Unsung Hero Award. This award will be presented annually to one administrator, faculty, or staff member whose hard work and dedication behind the scenes have made a noticeable impact on the school environment and the student experience. This past September, a new plaque was unveiled at High School East, which will have an engraved nameplate for each award winner for future generations to see. This year, the winner of the Shenandehowa High School Unsung Hero Award goes to Mr. Daniel Zapola. Mr. Zapola is Shenandehowa High School's head custodian. He was nominated by the High School Partnership Team for his dedication to the entire high school community. It is truly an honor to present this award to Mr. Daniel Zapola. The Shenandehowa United Supervisors Association Award. This is awarded to a student who has shown the most improvement in their class this year. This year, the recipient is Ian Rivette. The Shenandehowa STA Anthony McCain Scholarship. This award is given to a graduating senior based on teacher recommendation. This year, the recipient is Liam Carlson. The Shenandehowa STA Secondary Education Scholarship. This scholarship is presented to a student planning to major in secondary education. It is given on the basis of academic achievement and character. This year, the recipient is Sarah Casal. The Shenandehowa STA Elementary Education Scholarship. This scholarship is presented to a student planning to major in elementary education. It is given on the basis of academic achievement and character. This year, the recipient is Michaela Kogelar. The Clifton Park Elks Lodge, number 246666, BPOE Award. This award is presented to a graduating senior who has shown outstanding leadership accomplishments in the awareness of drug prevention. This year, the recipient is Kate Bartoletti. The Clifton Park Half Moon Piranhas Community Service Award. This scholarship is presented to a graduating Shenandehowa student who has exhibited great character, volunteered their time, and has given back to their community. All assets that are important to the Clifton Park Half Moon Piranha Swim Team. This year, the recipient is Isabella Saleka. Hudson Adirondack Daylily Society Scholarship. This is being awarded to a local graduating high school student majoring in a field of environmental or biological sciences. This year's recipient goes to well-deserving. This year, the recipient is a well-deserving student who has expressed an interest in his or her environment through their future college studies. This year, the recipient is Samantha Bjorklund. The Mallory Family Merit Scholarship for 2020. This is presented to a senior who has the intention of receiving a four-year degree. They must have good academic standing for the duration of their high school career with a focus on studying to achieve a degree as their ultimate goal. The recipient will receive an additional 3 years at $4,000 each year based on their academic standing. It will be the responsibility of the recipient to provide Shenandoah High School principal proof of college enrollment and GPA of the previous year. This year, the recipient is Haley Wade. The Zonta Club of Schenectady International Program, the Community Service Award. The goal of the Zonta International Young Women in Public Affairs Award Program is to encourage more young women to participate in public affairs by recognizing the commitment to the volunteer sector, evidence of volunteer leadership achievements, and a dedication to the advancement of the status of women. This year, the recipient is Tressa Grant. The Larry Hawk Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is in memory of Larry, father of Katie and John, a 2013 Shen graduate, and Robbie, who graduated in 2011. It has been established for a deserving student who best exemplifies his or her qualities of kindness, compassion, integrity, and humor during their high school years. On behalf of Ms. Pekka, president of the foundation, I will be reading their message. Kyle Meyer, this year's recipient, has been selected for the Larry Hawk Memorial Scholarship. Kyle exemplifies the criteria of the scholarship with his character, positive attitude, integrity, sense of humor, compassion for others, and strong work ethic. Please join me in congratulating the recipient, Kyle Meyer. The Deanna Marie Rivers Memorial Scholarship. The Deanna Marie Rivers Memorial Scholarship was created in 2013 to honor the life of an amazing young lady. Deanna passed away in an automobile accident December 1st, 2012, along with fellow Shenandoah classmate and dear friend Christopher Stewart. Deanna was a member of the Shenandoah class of 2013. Deanna will always be remembered for her infectious smile, kind heart, her love of learning, and the way she embraced life through her involvement in sports, work, and community service. On behalf of Mr. and Mrs. Rivers and Jenna Rivers, I will read their message. Deanna was a member of Shenandoah's graduating class of 2013 until she was taken from us. Her family, friends, class, and the 508 community, due to an impaired driver under the influence of alcohol, drugs, texting, and speeding on December 1st, 2012. We will always remember Deanna for her beautiful smile, her love for our family, her friends, and her ability to brighten up any room that she walked into. Deanna's passion was always to bring out the best in everyone, and that is what she did. No matter the situation, she carried herself with a positive attitude through happiness and adversity. Deanna had a great personality with a sense of humor and laughed each day with enthusiasm and excitement. Deanna's competitive spirit is what made her the student athlete she was. Sadly, Deanna did not get to graduate or attend college. She had the best days ahead of her, but never got the chance to live them because of circumstances beyond her control. Just like all of you, Deanna walked out of school on a Friday to never return the following Monday. This has had us thinking more and more about this class. The class of 2020, realizing that individually and as a class, you were forced to make adjustments. Remember that this is not the first time your vision for the future has changed, and it probably will not be the last. Our hope is that during your adjustment, you were able to create good memories with your family and to build on that foundation before you head off to college. Your memories at Shen will be with you forever, but remember, you are off to experience bigger things. We want you to know that your hard work and accomplishments have not gone unnoticed by your community. Always hope for the best, and most importantly, be kind to one another. Deanna had a love for children and wanted to become a teacher and help children to be the best they could be. Deanna had plans to attend the College of St. Rose to pursue a teaching career. She was accepted with a presidential scholarship just one day prior to her accident. We will forever be proud of her many accomplishments. In and out of school, on and off the field, and the many lives she touched in the very short time, we were all blessed to have her. We believe both recipients tonight possess the same traits that Deanna was proud to be known for. Their love of family, compassion, and a positive attitude. We would like to thank everyone who submitted an application, and after much consideration, it is our honor to present and extend our warmest congratulations and support to the Deanna Marie Rivers Scholarship recipients. This year, the recipients are Alana Tremblay and Thomas Landers. We know you will do remarkable things in the future. Congratulations. The Erica Lynn Ledoux Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a college-bound senior with a fervent desire to help children in the fields of teaching and education, social work, or child care. The recipient must possess and demonstrate a genuine optimistic attitude in word and deed with a love of writing or a desire to improve his or her writing ability. This year, the recipient is Elena Tremblay. The Jeffrey Andrew Zerpak Memorial Scholarship. This award is presented to a varsity swim team senior in memory of Jeffrey Andrew Zerpak, a class of 2001 graduate. On behalf of the Zerpak family, I'm happy to congratulate this year's recipient, Zachary Lassiter. This scholarship was created by Tina's family, friends and colleagues, and students in honor of her life. This award is presented to a senior who plans to pursue an education, a career in education, specifically elementary education. On behalf of Mr. and Mrs. Wood and Mrs. Sievers, I will be reading their message. Tina always wanted to be a teacher. Her dream of returning to the school district she grew up was realized when she was hired to teach at Ate Elementary School. She used her interest in arts, travel, cultures, and music to create a dynamic classroom. But it was her love of teaching children and life that most impacted her students. It is hoped that this year's recipient will also bring passion and enthusiasm to her future students. This year's recipient of the Tina A. Daly Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $5,000 is Abigail Hurd. The Daniel J. Holsterman Memorial Scholarship. This is presented to a student who is highly creative, exhibits dedication to excellence, depth of understanding, has positive and mature attitude to life, and will be pursuing higher education in architecture. To present this scholarship, please welcome a video from Ms. Connie Holsterman.
Hello, honored members of Shenandoah class of 2020. I greet you. I want to tell you about your generation. Back in the 1990s, two men, Strauss and Howe, wrote a book about the characteristics of each generation. You've heard about the generations, the greatest, the silent, the boomers, the millennials. Well, your class, because you're all born after 2000, 2000, people have taken to calling you Generation Zero. But I do not call you that. I call you the resilient generation because you've already shown how resilient you are. Please look up resiliency and see the characteristics that you are already showing. Now I want to tell you about my award. It is in loving memory of my son, Daniel John Holsterman. He graduated from Shenandoah in 1984, went on to Carnegie Mellon Institute in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, to study architecture. Unfortunately, in the summer after his freshman year, right here on Grooms Road, he was killed by a drunk driver. So, in memory of him, I give this award to someone who is going on in the field of fine arts and has a mature attitude toward life. And that is Beatrice Johnson Drysdale. Best wishes to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Holsterman, and congratulations to Beatrice Johnson Drysdale. Our next award is the Christopher F. Stewart Memorial Scholarship. This is in loving memory of Christopher F. Stewart, a member of the class of 2013, who was killed tragically on December 1st, 2012. This award will be presented to seniors who have demonstrated an involvement and participation in a wide array of Shenandoah activities and or involvement in their community from kindergarten through grade 12. They are also continuing their education in a 2 or 4 year college or trade school. On behalf of Mr. and Mrs. Stewart and Jeremy Stewart, I will be reading their message. As each year passes, it becomes more apparent that the graduating class never got to meet or know our son Christopher, unless they have a much older sibling. But if you're fortunate enough to have a best friend at school, suffice to say, you would have had another in Chris, no matter if you're male or female. He would have been over to your house on many occasions, visiting with your family, whether or not you were home. Chris was an extrovert, a conversationalist, and a big boy willing and able to help pick things up and put them down. You and your siblings would have considered him instant family. His smile, hearty laugh, and gentle demeanor made everyone feel comfortable in his presence. He would join in and play video games, help with homework, or just chat with younger brothers and sisters, and parents loved him because he didn't mind doing chores. One year, he put up all the Christmas decorations at a friend's house, including dragging down the boxes from the attic and hanging outdoor wreaths from the second floor. All this while his friend was not even home. The spirit of Chris will last forever in the halls of Shenandoah. He loved going to school each day. He did his best in learning to speak Spanish, mastering public speaking, and writing stories in English classes, and was known to take a second gym class during a study period just because he liked running around. He very much liked lunchtime in the cafeteria so he could visit with friends and sample their meal in addition to his own. From time to time, other parents would send their child with treats just for Chris. Or maybe his friends caught on to his antics and had their parents pack more so they could get some too. One parent even had a Christopher-only snack cabinet in their home. A corner cupboard exclusively for him with a big yellow post-it stuck to it. It was written in black Sharpie. No one was to eat anything in it but Chris. He was a true gem of a kid and had an appetite for life and for food. There was no question that one of Christopher's passions was football at Shen, but he tried many different sports and clubs. Cello was probably the one and only thing he did not stick with. His fingers were too chubby, and learning it was not physical enough for him. Not to mention he had to be quiet during practice and concerts. That only lasted 1 year, fifth grade. His true passion was the friendships he made with classmates, teachers, and coaches. That bond is forever, and Chris treasured it. We would like to say thank you to everyone that applied for Chris's scholarship this year. It is always difficult to select. Please know, all applications were given a thorough review, not only by us, but by Christopher's older brother, Jeremy. We are honored to announce that the recipients of the 2020 Christopher F. Stewart Memorial Scholarships are Alexandra Picard and Jack McQuaid. Congratulations to both of you. The Ray W. Shade Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to a student with 4 high school credits in either math or science and is accepted and plans to attend a 2 or 4 year college. The recipient was selected from a group of students who have dedicated their commitment to their education through perseverance in their studies and through continuous growth throughout their high school career. They are willing to go the extra mile, stick with the course, and ultimately succeed. On behalf of Mrs. Shade, Karen Shade, and Pat McKenzie, I will be reading their message. Over 20 years ago, Ray Shade, a retired GE engineer, created the CARE Lings Volunteer Tutoring Program at Shenandoah. This unique program, staffed by volunteer engineers, scientists, and teachers from the community, provides an additional place for any Shen student who is seeking extra help in math or science. It is designed for all students. When Ray passed away in 2005, his wife Nancy and daughter Karen established the Ray W. Shade Memorial Scholarship to recognize a graduating senior who reflects Ray's commitment to education. This year's award winner is a regular participant in the Extra Help program. She's always so optimistic and energetic, always greeting everyone with a big smile, no matter how her day is going. Her compassion and desire to help others define her outlook on life. The tutors have always been impressed with her perseverance, hard work, and dedication to her schoolwork. She always wants to fully understand what she is learning. As such, she exemplifies what Ray and this award is all about, valuing education and being willing to put out that extra effort to get the most out of it. She plans on continuing her education in the Physician Assistant Program at Massachusetts College of Pharmacy and Health Sciences. Based on her attitude and hard work, we know she will be a success there too. We are proud to award the 2020 Ray W. Shade Memorial Scholarship to Gabriella Pierre Lewis. The Elaine Edelson Memorial Scholarship. Elaine Edelson was a social studies teacher at Shenandoah for over 25 years. She was also Gowanus Yearbook Advisor. Elaine dedicated her professional life to improving the lives of her students. This award, presented by her family, continues to honor her memory. The award is given annually to a graduating senior pursuing a college education. The recipient will show academic excellence with a GPA of 90 or higher for their high school career. They will show a strong sense of citizenship. Consideration will be given to prospective teachers. This year, the recipient is Emma Norris. The Elizabeth Campbell Burke Memorial Scholarship. This is presented to seniors for all their hard work. A student who is involved in his or her community, extracurricular activities, and possesses strong academic achievement. This award was created by Captain David E. Burke of the United States Navy in memory of his wife, Elizabeth Campbell Burke, to honor her memory and carry on the legacy of selflessness and success. Elizabeth was a Shen graduate in the class of 1992. She was killed in an automobile accident on June 21st, 1997. The recipients this year are Jessica Gordon and Samantha Ivy. The Natalie Rose Mean Memorial Scholarship. This is an award given to a senior who has demonstrated determination, they have a positive attitude, and are kind to others. This year, the recipient is Benjamin Casino Hernandez. The Zachary P. Morrissey Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is in remembrance of Zachary Morrissey, a member of the class of 2015. The recipient of this scholarship must be planning on attending a 2 or 4 year college and plan to work in the human services field. The recipient must have overcome adversity in their high school career and display a hard work ethic, be outgoing, and show empathy for others. To present this scholarship are Mr. Morrissey and the Morrissey family.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Mike Morrissey. On behalf of my family, we wanted to say that we know this isn't how the class of 2020 pictured the end of the senior year, but we also know this will only be a minor setback for what is to come for all of you. This scholarship is in remembrance of my triplet brother, Zachary Morrissey, who was a member of the 2015 graduating class. Zachary was an outgoing, funny, and caring young man, but on the inside, however, he felt insecure, sad, anxious, and alone. Zachary was fortunate enough to have people in his life that understood his challenges, but his life was taken before he could realize that he was not alone. No one chooses to deal with anxiety, depression, or to become addicted to drugs or alcohol. We encourage you, as soon-to-be high school graduates and parents, become educated and aware of these diseases, especially during this pandemic, and to know that if you suffer from these or any adversity, you are not alone. In Zachary's honor, we would like to present this year's scholarship to a student who has overcome a great deal of adversity. This student will be attending SUNY Brockport in the fall to pursue a degree in biology. His persistence and perseverance is truly inspiring. We are happy to award this year's scholarship to Michael Marincik. Congratulations, Michael.
Thank you, Morrissey family, and congratulations to Michael Marincik. The Tina Bianchi Memorial Scholarship. Tina Bianchi was a positive, caring, compassionate, and helpful person who was loved by everyone who knew her. She was an admired and respected teacher and mentor at Shenandoah for 32 years. This award will be presented to a graduating senior who exemplifies Tina's personal characteristics and her love for helping others. This year, the award winner is Hannah Pantia. The Kenneth J. Plummer Memorial CSEA Unit 8458 Scholarship. This scholarship will be awarded to a college-bound senior who is the son or daughter of a member of this CSEA unit and employed at Shenandoah Central Schools. Award selection was based on academic achievement and outstanding character as demonstrated by community service, employment, sports, and family responsibilities. This year, the recipient is Jacob DiRenzo. The Robert J. Foster Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is presented to a Round Lake resident who best exemplifies the following characteristics: service to the village of Round Lake, creativity, and love of life. This year, the recipient is Sydney Morell. The Aaron J. Block Memorial Athletic Scholarship. This award is presented to an outstanding scholar-athlete who personifies sportsmanship, teamwork, and outstanding participation in scholastic ability. To present this award, please welcome Mr. Eric Edson.
Congratulations to Evan Bean on winning the Aaron Block Memorial Scholarship Award. Evan, I'm super proud to present you this award. Aaron was a wonderful friend of mine who unfortunately left this earth much too soon. But he was a great athlete, a tenacious competitor, and just an all-around awesome kid. And to see you receiving it is really great because you are completely representative of everything that he stood for. So best of luck moving forward, and I hope everybody's well.
Thank you, Mr. Edson, and congratulations, Evan Bean. The Ronald Jacobs Theatrical Excellence Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to seniors who exhibit strong dedication to and a passion for theater arts. The recipient must have been a member of the high school drama and musical company for at least 2 years. This year, the recipients are Madeline Tansman and Alana Tremblay. The Clifton Park Half Moon Emergency Corps Award. The CPHM is proud to offer this scholarship to a senior entering an accredited post-secondary institution in a healthcare-related field. Applicants meet a number of requirements to qualify, and CPHM truly enjoys supporting young men and women who choose to seek a career in healthcare. Congratulations to this year's recipient, Michael Marincic. Grand Lodge Knights of Pythias Award. This medal is presented to the student who has made the greatest progress in extracurricular activities and or community endeavors while maintaining an excellent academic record. This year, the recipient, Elizabeth Swatling. The Upstate New York Hospice Society. This scholarship is being awarded to a local graduating high school student majoring in a field of environmental or biological sciences. Our society is a local gardening group consisting of approximately 100 members who share their love, for the perennial plant known as the hosta. The society scholarship was established in order to encourage youth to become more aware of this perennial and the importance of caring for our environment, as well as a deeper understanding of the importance of diversified landscapes throughout our world. It is our pleasure that this year's $1,000 scholarship winner goes to this deserving young lady who has expressed to us her sincere interest in her environment through her future college studies. This year, the recipient is Samantha Bjornklund. The Clifton Park Fire Department Award. This is presented to the most improved seniors living in the Clifton Park Half Moon Fire District. This year, the recipients are Maria Carzo and Paul Getz III. the Clifton Park Fire Department Ladies Auxiliary Award, awarded to the most improved senior in 4 years of high school and resides in the Clifton Park Fire District. This year, the recipient is Caitlin Villiam. The Half Moon Waterford Fire Company American Studies Scholarship. This award is presented to seniors who demonstrate an outstanding academic record and class standing with community and volunteer activities who also reside in the Half Moon Fire District. This year, the recipients are Taylor Pazerski and Brianna Woodworth. The Jonesville Fire Company Award. This is awarded to a senior in the Jonesville Fire District who has shown outstanding leadership accomplishments and community activities and who plans to enter public service. This year, the recipient is Madison Boss. The Jonesville Ladies Auxiliary Memorial Award. This is awarded to a senior in the Jonesville Fire District with a strong history of community service. The recipient will have high academic achievement and will be a hard worker in and out of school. This year, the recipient is Anna Perez. The Vischer Ferry Fire Company Patrick Bloodgood Memorial Award. This is awarded to a worthy senior who resides in the Vischer Ferry Fire District or is a member of the Vischer Ferry Fire Company. This year, the recipient, Julia Art. The Vischer Ferry Fire Company Ladies Auxiliary Award. Awarded to a worthy senior who is a relative of a member of the fire department or a fire department auxiliary with the highest academic average. This year, the recipient is Alexis Jerome. The Shen Helping Shen Scholarship in memory of Darlene Butterer. This award celebrates a student who exemplifies the qualities of perseverance, humility, encouragement, and kindness. This student demonstrates dedication and exhibits their best regardless of any circumstances. This year, the recipient is Leslie Yates. The Best Buddies Volunteer Award, awarded to a senior who is attending college to study special education or a related field, OT, PT, speech, psych, counseling, etc. And they've had a vital role in the Best Buddies Club. This year, the recipient is Kate Bartoletti. The Captain Community Human Services Tiffany Suzanne Phillips Distinguished Citizenship Award. Captain Community Human Services is pleased to present the 2020 Tiffany Suzanne Phillips Distinguished Citizenship Award. This award is given to a Shenandoah senior who enjoys art, fashion, and/or music, and they're also a great friend to others. The Tiffany Suzanne Phillips Distinguished Citizen Award this year goes to Caitlin Lyons. The Earl B. Fiden Appliance Award for Drunk Driving Prevention. Earl B. Fiden Appliance is offering a $1,000 scholarship to a member of this year's graduating class who's participated in the Shenandoah High School Anti-Drunk Driving Billboard Design Campaign. This award honors a student who has dedicated time during her high school years in developing a positive, well-researched message highlighting the disastrous impact that impaired driving has had on their community. This award is not dependent on academic merit, but rather the amount of effort that is put forth by the student in understanding and communicating the impact of impaired driving. Our hope is this message will be one that students carry forth as they are faced with making responsible decisions at this critical time in their lives. There are many things in our life we cannot control. This is one we can. Drunk driving is preventable. Make good decisions and save lives. This year, the recipient of the Earl B. Fiden Appliance Award is Charlotte Miller. The Shenandoah High School PTSA Senior Scholarship. This award recognizes high school seniors who have demonstrated good character and service as evidenced by their participation in Shen's PTSA and volunteers in high school and community activities. This year, the recipients are Priya Duda, Jason Marincic, and Michael Marincic. The PTSA Neil Hessen Awards. This award is named after Neil Hessen, who was the first president of the PTSA and presented on the basis of outstanding citizenship, strong academic record, character, integrity, and service to school and fellow students. This year, the recipients are Julia Arp and Peter Sharma. The Shenandoah PTA Council Award for Volunteerism. This is presented to a college-bound senior based on community service, volunteerism, and given in the name of James Grandin, former Board of Education member. This year, the recipient is Jack Bose. The Shenandoah Rotary Scholarship. The Rotary Club of Shenandoah awards this scholarship to the student that is judged to display the best combination of dedication to school, involvement in school activities, dedication to community, volunteerism, and dedication to work. They must be employed and demonstrate good work habits. They are looking to enroll in a vocational school or 2 or 4 year college or university. This year, the recipient is Devin Kennedy. The Ranjan Elementary School PTA Scholarship. This is presented to graduating seniors who graduated from Ranjan, having attended a minimum of 2 years. This is based on academic achievement and outstanding character as demonstrated by community service, employment, sports, or extracurricular involvement. This year, the recipients are Bianca Carzo and Jack Bose. The Chengo Elementary School PTA Scholarship. This is presented to deserving members of the senior class who formerly attended and graduated from Chengo. Evaluation is based on academic achievement, extracurricular activities, sports, community activities, and or employment. This year, the recipients are Sarah Casal and Sydney Morell. The Carrigan Elementary PTA Academic Scholarship, presented to 2 seniors who attended Carrigan for at least 2 years and are applying to a 2 or 4 year college. This year, the recipient, Samantha Ivy. The Carrigan Elementary School PTA Community Service Scholarship. This is presented to a senior who attended Carrigan for at least 2 years and is applying to a 2 or 4 year college. This year, the recipient is Kate Bartoletti. The Octe Elementary School PTA Scholarship, awarded to seniors who attended Octe Elementary, has excelled academically and demonstrates traits of outstanding character and service. The recipient must attend the moving up ceremony and address the graduating class. This year, the recipients are Anna Gerhardt and Jessica Gordon. The Renda Elementary School PTA Scholarship. These 2 scholarships are awarded to seniors who attend a 2 or 4 year school and have attended Arenda for at least 3 years. They demonstrate outstanding service to school community and academics. This year, the recipients are Olivia Benamore and Tiffany Pottenberg. The Shattuckon Elementary School PTA Scholarship. This is presented to seniors who will be attending a 2 or 4 year college, university, or certificate program and who have led a balanced life throughout high school. They will demonstrate their balanced life through participation in community service organizations, volunteerism, extracurricular activities, employment, and or additional special circumstances. This year, the recipients are Haley Evertson and Taylor Pazderski. The Scano Elementary School Lisa Kuhn's Scholarship. This is presented to a senior who graduated from and attended Scano for at least 2 years. It's based on well-rounded background as well as academic achievement, character, and a written essay. This scholarship is offered in memory of Lisa Kuhns, a parent who did a lot for Scano and the community and passed away in 2005 from cancer. This year, the recipient is Emily Bridgeford. The Scano Elementary School PTA Academic Scholarship. This is presented to a senior who graduated from and attended Scano for at least 2 years. It's based on well-rounded background, as well as academic achievement, character, and a written essay. This year, the recipients are Victoria Willard and Emma Wise. The Tasago Elementary School PTA Vincent R. DeLuca Scholarship. This awards two graduating seniors who have enrolled in a 2 or 4 year college or university and demonstrate a combination of academic performance and involvement in service to the community. Recipients must be a graduate of Tasago who attended for at least 2 years. This year, the recipients are Priya Duda and Anna Perez. The Acadia Middle School PTA Scholarship. Presented to graduating seniors who will go on to either 2 or 4 year college or technical school. They have demonstrated participation in some of the following areas: extracurriculars, in service, sports, clubs, family responsibilities, employment, and or music. They must have attended Acadia for at least 1 year and graduated from Acadia. Students must have satisfactory academic records. This year, the recipients are Matthew Carpenter and Megan Mahar. The Gowanna Middle School PTA Academic Scholarship. Students must have attended Gowanna Middle School for at least 2 years. The major emphasis of this scholarship award will be on student academic achievement and involvement in extracurricular activities, sports, and service activities. This year, the recipient is Annabelle Sala. The Gowanna Middle School PTA Community Scholarship. The student must have attended Gowanna Middle School for at least 2 years. The major emphasis of this scholarship is on student academic achievement and involvement in extracurricular activities, sports, and service activities. This year, the recipient is Colin Cook. The COTA Middle School PTA Scholarship. This is presented to seniors who attended COTA for at least 2 years. This year, the recipients are Maria Carza and Alana Tremblay. The Shenandoah Class of 2017 Scholarship. An award shall be given each year to a senior who shows commitment to extracurricular activities, encourages peers, and demonstrates care for the community. This year, the recipient is Yuri Wang. The Hudson Valley Community College Book Award, awarded to a senior who will be attending Hudson Valley Community College in the fall and is recognized for their hard work and individuality. This year, the recipient is Durrani Catterby. The Sharon DuPont Award. This award is presented to a senior who exhibits courage beyond the normal concerns of their daily life, dedication, giving of oneself, character and motivation in a self-sacrificing manner. This year, the recipient is Francesca Carza. The Saratoga Hospital Volunteer Guild Scholarship. Since 1990, the Saratoga Hospital Volunteer Guild has offered scholarships to high school seniors in Saratoga County that are interested in healthcare careers. This year, the Guild chose 5 highly deserving students, all of whom plan to attend college in the fall of 2020. All the recipients plan a career in medicine and have documented community service, both attributes especially important during these challenging times. Congratulations to these outstanding students, each of whom will receive a $1,500 scholarship. This scholarship is awarded to high school seniors planning to enter college curriculum in medical field, including, but not limited to, pre-med, nursing, biomedical research, pharmacy, medical technology, medical imaging, physical therapy, respiratory therapy, physician's assistant, mental health, occupational therapy, and healthcare management. This year, the recipient is Baiha Sun. The Southern Saratoga Garden Club Award. This award is presented to a worthy senior pursuing college-level work in the following areas: horticulture, landscape design, environmental conservation and management, or forestry. This year, the recipient is Megha Chatterjee. the Linda DeCruz Harper Memorial Scholarship given by Southern Saratoga County Women's Club. This scholarship is awarded to seniors who demonstrate an outstanding academic record and displays outstanding citizenship who is planning on attending either a 2 or 4 year college. This year, the recipients are Dawson Maloney, Analysia Millite, Tyler Sullivan, and Emily Sweeney. The American Legion Mohawk Post 1450 American Studies Academic Scholarship. This is awarded to seniors based on academic record, class standing, and academic record in American Studies. This year, the recipients are Matthew Carpenter, Taylor Pazerski, Matilda Tristan, and Lauren Vandenberg. The American Legion Auxiliary Mohawk Unit 1450 Award. This is presented to a senior who displays outstanding citizenship and service to the community. This year, the recipient is Caitlin Jennings. The STAT Staff Professionals Computer Science Scholarship. This award is presented to a senior who has been accepted in a computer science program. They have a GPA of 3.0 or higher and have good morals and are committed to caring. This year, the recipient is Sarah Golden. The STAT Staff Professionals Healthcare Education Scholarship. This award is presented to a senior who has accepted an offer to enroll in a healthcare education program. They have a GPA of 3.0 or higher and possess good morals and are committed to caring. This year, the recipient is Sana Shazad. The Mohawk Valley 1495 Harold C. Kittle Scholarship. This is presented in memory of Harold C. Kittle, a longtime Grangemaster and member of Mohawk Valley 1495. This is awarded to a student who plans to pursue working in the field of agriculture, veterinary medicine, or ecology. This year, the recipient is Hannah Brown. The Julia O. Wells Memorial Education Scholarship. This is presented to a senior who has been accepted into a 2 or 4 year accredited registered professional nursing program. This year, the recipient is Peyton Zofi. The Malta Sunrise Rotary Club Award. This scholarship seeks to recognize high school seniors who reside in the town of Malta and have maintained academic excellence and have served their community during their high school years. This year, the recipient is Lauren Vandenberg. The Amazon Future Engineer Scholarship. This award was given to 50 students throughout the nation who did well in computer science during their high school years. The recipient must be enrolled in a full-time undergraduate course of study at an accredited 4-year college or university and will major in computer science, software engineering, computer engineering, or other computer-related field of study. The scholarship includes a paid internship at Amazon writing software. This year, the recipient is Nicole Cheatham. Shenandoah High School Administrators Award. This award is given to a student who exemplifies effort, hard work, citizenship, and cooperation throughout their high school career. This year, the recipient is Caitlin Villum. The School Alliance of Substitutes in Education Award, SASE. The SASE Award is presented to a graduating senior who will be pursuing higher education in 4-year college, 2-year college, or trade school. It's presented to solid students who are involved in extracurricular activities and is a child or grandchild of a SASE member. This year, the School Alliance of Substitutes in Education Award goes to Isabella Saleka. The SFA Senate Richard E. Kelly Award. This award is named in honor of the founder of the Student Faculty Administration Senate. The Richard E. Kelly Award recognizes senior members of the Student Faculty Administration Senate for their 4 years of service, dedication, and excellence to the SFA Senate and to the Shenandoah community. This year, the recipient is Chase Talheimer. The SFA Senate Award for Excellence. This award recognizes a senior member of the Student Faculty Administration Senate for their outstanding service to the SFA Senate, to the school, and to the Shenandoah community. This year, the recipient is Bianca Carza. The National Honor Society recognition. This year, Shenandoah High School National Honor Society is proud to offer a scholarship to a member who has demonstrated a willingness to fulfill the society's four pillars in their pursuit of academic excellence and service to the community while exhibiting superior character. This year, the recipient is Victoria Willard. The Carol Barlow Award. This is presented to a graduating senior who will be furthering his or her education after graduation and who expends 100% effort in athletics and academics. This year, the recipient is Simone Walker. The Patrick D. Casey Memorial Award. This award is a coach's choice for a senior football player who displayed a commitment to off-season training, leadership, on and off the field, and academic achievement in the classroom. This year, the recipient is Kevin Faubert. The Roy Lang Memorial Award. This award is presented to the student for the win beneath the team's wings. It is based on 75% athletics and 25% academics for any sport. This year, the recipient is Duncan Hill. The Harrison Hubbard Award. This is awarded to a deserving girl active in interscholastic sports and school activities during her high school career. This year, the recipient is Abby Danson. The Coach's Trophy Award, presented to student athletes who best exemplify all the attributes of complete dedication. The 2020 recipients are Emily Carroll, Jade Dennis, Alexander Fabris, Jalen Sykes, and Zachary Trump. The Shen Trophy Award. This is awarded annually by the Shenandoah Athletic Department to outstanding graduating interscholastic athletes who exemplify qualities of leadership, citizenship, and academic achievement. This year, the recipients are William Beach, Daniel Casey, and Jacob Reinisch. The Shenandoah Dollars for Scholars. Dollars for Scholars will be awarding 23 scholarships for a total of $17,750. The Shenandoah Dollars for Scholars Award ceremony date has not yet been determined, but students will be receiving information in the future. The 2020 recipients are Hannah Bellevue, Samantha Borkland, Mary Ruchero, Paige Canterbury, Matthew Carpenter, Bianca Carzo, Jacob Dorenzo, Dominic Emphasis, Heba Fahim, Kevin Faubert, Caitlin Jennings, Christopher Lee, Michael Marincic, Jason Marincic, Michael Odo, Anna Perez, Ryan Shanahan, Harlan Sani, Michaela Sarad, Lauren Spiegel, Baihai Sun, and Emily Sweeney. This concludes our 2020 Senior Award Ceremony. We thank you for watching. We look forward to celebrating our seniors at the 2020 commencement exercises in a few weeks. Thank you all, and have a great night.